Hey Libra, I hope that you're doing well. This is a general reading for you. The focus period is from the 1st until the 12th of June. But beautiful stone over there. Whenever you see it, it's obviously the right time for you to see it. Welcome to my channel. Thank you for all your likes, shares, comments, and subscriptions. I'm truly grateful for all of that. So I'm going to draw you some tarot for your recent past, your current energy, what's coming towards you. We're going to clarify. At the end of the reading, I'm going to give you the opportunity to ask three questions and to then draw cards for those. But let's just first start off with an oracle card. See what angel prayers has got to say to us. This reading is focusing on love, romantic love. Please take it as it resonates. Remember, it's not a personal reading. Let's see. What do we have for Libra, please? The 1st till the 12th of June. What does Libra need to know about love? What does the angels want to Libra know about love? For the 1st of the 12th of June. Ooh, you lot are resilient, are you not? Nothing is coming up. Okay. I'm going to take that one, okay? Actually, no, I feel that one. I'm going to take that one. All right. Let's take this aside and see what this one is. It says, don't hate, meditate. Thank you, angels, for guiding me to love through meditation. This is a card, this is an energy, Libra, that that speaks of the fact, almost like what I can pick up, is that there might be many reasons for you to be unhappy. There might be many reasons for you to sort of be upset. There might be many reasons for you to be in a space of almost like frustration, really, you know, almost like anger, in a sense. But you are being encouraged not to stay with that, but to go into a silent space, to let the universe, you know, in a sense, allow the beauty to come to you. Okay. Because there's lots of beauty that's available. When life asks us to slow down, there is always a good reason for that. And we are always the ones that benefit from that reason. Okay. Alrighty. Let's see what we've got here with Muse Tarot for your recent pass. Oh, we've got two cards. Okay. And let's take another one. So what do we have? We've got the Nine of Materials, which is the Nine of Wands, and we've got the Devil card over here. Okay. Then we've got the Justice card, and we've got the Ten of Inspiration. So this is you being called, really, Libra, to really like a higher sense of being, you know, because there's what a lot of the hopes that wanted to come true. And now I can see why many of you, like the collective of you, was resilient to get a message for love, because for many of you, you are focused sort of on yourself, on your well-being, you know, on your own basic experience of life, looking after yourself, providing for yourself, you know. And I see that for many of you there, especially in the recent past, you started to release from the things that were holding you back from your stability, holding you back from your happiness, holding you back from your joy, holding you back from anything really where you cannot be the person who sort of make the final decisive, you know, sort of decisions in your life. And there you started to come out of it. And basically into your own energy there with the Justice card, Libra, there in the recent past, you started to get success there. That's beautiful. So I feel that for most of you, your focus in life was more sort of you, you know, not so much love specifically. Cards that we have here for you, for your current energy, the Four of Emotions, which is the Four of Cups, the Seven of Materials, as well as the Three of Emotions. This is quite incredible, actually. Because this speaks about maybe being hesitant, saying, you know what, I'm not sure that it's for me. I don't think I want to do that. I don't feel that it's a good, you know, sort of like an option for me. Going to a space of like, it could work if only not for this and if only not for that, you know. So you can see the things that need to be worked on. But I also see, I see something beautiful there for you. Many reasons to celebrate there for you in your current energy. Many reasons to celebrate in love. So for many of you, you may feel that you've tried for a while and it just wasn't happening. Well, it's beginning to happen. Let's see what we've got coming towards you. So you've got the Muse of Voices, first of all, which is the King of Swords. Beautiful celebration sort of energy there coming your way. You've got the Five of Voices, which again is the Five of Swords. And you've got the Five of Materials, which is the Five of Pentacles. So going forward, I see you finding love. I see you finding that beautiful person. I see you finding that beautiful energy. But what you want to be careful of, Libra, and this is something that can happen with us as human beings sometimes, is that when you find that one, you sometimes lose focus on everything else. So just be careful of that. Okay. Let's clarify using the Rider-Waite Tarot for you. Clarify the recent past there for Libra. What love? What is it that they need to know? Pertaining to love specifically. What do they need to know? Let's see. What does Libra need to know? Oh, okay. Another seven. Oh, deck is not in reverse. You know, just look. So we've got the Seven of Cups. We've got the Queen of Wands in reverse. We've got the Knight of Pentacles in reverse. All right. Now, first of all, when you get a card in reverse, please don't trip. Sometimes people see, you know, I teach like my tarot classes. I've got an online course as well. There's a link in the description if you want to look at that. But also my private classes. And you know, I have learned by now that to speak about reverse cards very early in the course, you know, because a reverse card is not bad at all, not even the slightest. And remember, tarot is just a guide. Yeah, there were, I feel for some of you, you were sort of, when it comes to love, for many of you in the recent past there, it was a no. You were like, not interested in love right now, okay? You were more focusing inwards within yourself, seeing how you can really maneuver things for yourself in such a way that you have a pleasant experience of life. I feel that was very necessary for many of you. Now we're looking at your current energy. So we've got that Four of Emotions, which is the Four of Cups. We've got the Seven of Materials, which is the Seven of Pentacles, and the Three of Emotions, which is the Three of Cups. And let's grab our deck here again. Let's see what we have for clarifiers for this particular part. Okay. I normally shuffle them until I feel like I, you know, and then I will stop. So for the Four of Cups, you've got the Two of Wands. So, you know, I feel that maybe you made a beautiful connection, but you've got some doubts because, you know, if you just met someone or you're with someone, this is the energy of a person that says, you know, how about maybe we get together, but we go do it over there. This is almost like somebody asking you to leave your comfort zone. You're like, I'm not prepared. Well, I'm not sure how prepared I am to do that at this point. Okay. Seven of Materials here with the Knight of Wands. So I feel that for many of you, because you're still sort of working on your finances over here and your sense of stability and strengthening and sort of like, you know, focusing on the loopholes, those sort of things, I see you being willing to sort of go with love and things like that, but this is probably more self-love. And then let's see what we've got here. Three of Emotions, which is the Three of Cups and the Six of Cups. Yeah. I feel that you've got clarity about what it is that you want to have, but you're also aware of the things within yourself and how you yourself might be holding yourself back. It's always good to be aware of that. Let's put it over here because that card is sort of sideways. And I thought I was being smart here by putting the camera at an angle, and now I'm trying to get a straight line and I can't. Let's see what's coming towards you. Oh, there's a card that fell to the floor. I'm going to pick it up for you. And look what it is. It's the Eight of Wands. Beautiful energy. Let's see what we have. Top of the deck, bottom of the deck. Yep. So this connection that you're making going forward, this is a really beautiful connection because this is a connection where you celebrate yourself, who you are. It's beautiful. But you've got doubts about it. I feel for some of you going forward, you're not sure if you're ready for this connection like you want it, but you may not be sure if you are ready for it yet. Okay. And then with the Five of Materials and the High Priestess over there, this is a very clear message for you, really. Because this Libra is a message that confirms to you that you are ready. You are ready to go to that next step, all right? And so just remember this going forward. When you're connected with someone and you're not sure if they're the one, you see sort of like the problems, the reasons why it may not work, for example, surrender to a higher source, surrender to the universe, and let the universe, you know, clear everything up for you, all right? Let's get to those three questions. I don't think I did thank all of you for your support of my channel in the beginning of the reading, and I apologize If I didn't, I can't remember now, but I got carried away with this reading. It's so beautiful. But thank you really for all of you who subscribe, comment, share, hit the notification bell here every week, you know, for the beautiful donations. I appreciate it. So this is a space where you get to ask three questions, and those three questions do not necessarily have to pertain to love. All right. So I'm going to give you just a moment there to ask your question. You get three of them. Here's the first one. The first one says that the situation will improve, okay? So if you are maybe feeling where you are at the moment, will things get better, will things improve, that sort of things, the situation will improve, okay? So that's confirmation number one. Let's get it in a straight line. Question number two. Libra, what do you want? What do you need for question number two? Okay. Question number two, that's a very, very beautiful, big, affirmative yes there for you. This card also always makes me think of worlds merging, you know? Like going from one space, which could be perfect, but going to a space that's even more perfect, all right? Great improvement. Great improvement awaiting you, Libra. And even with love, really, overall, great improvement. You can expect that, really, okay? Let's see. You can expect really great things. Question number three, we've got peaceful resolution. How beautiful is that? So the situation will improve, absolutely yes, and a peaceful resolution. I hope that helps, Libra. I'll see you next week. Bye.